Look what the wind has uncovered at Giga Berlin factory. You are seeing probably the four Tesla Model Y vehicles built at Giga Berlin that the wind has uncovered. These are screenshots from spotted by Daniel from FlyBrandenburg YouTube and Twitter channel. I'm using these images as a fair use, friends, for reporting purposes. I will have Daniel's video in the description of this report, so you can guys see it. So several Tesla Model Y vehicles have been spotted at Gigafactory Berlin. Production has been expected to start any day now, but official environmental approval is still uncertain, like I have said before in my reports. Over the last year, Tesla has run into a lot of red tape while trying to get approval to start production at Gigafactory Berlin, a giant new factory located near Berlin in Brandenburg. Most recently, environmental groups had managed to obtain an extension of the public commentary period for the project Giga Berlin, which delayed approval for another month. But there was also good news from the environmental organizations, as I reported just this morning. The new period concluded last month, and Tesla has been rumored to be on the verge of approval for Giga Berlin, but it has yet to happen. The Ministry for the Environment has now confirmed that it is still reviewing the comments and that Tesla apparently hasn't completed all the documents needed for the approval. Tagesspiegel, for example, reports that after the online consultations has been completed, the statements made will continue to be checked. In addition, the documents from the authorities and the developer Tesla are still pending. Brandenburg's Environment Minister Axel Vogel, as I reported a couple of days ago, echoed similar comments about some documents or reports missing in order to issue official approval. He told RBB that in order to be able to implement this legally, it is also necessary that appropriate reports are available. It is said that the case that not all reports are available in this quality. While several government officials commented on the project, no one wanted to bring forward a timeline for the environmental approval. In the meantime, Tesla appears to be making progress at the Gigafactory plant, with several Model Y bodies and even full vehicles spotted in a recent drone flyover. The drone flyover also spotted some scraps coming out of the plant, which could also be in an indication that some production work is ongoing. Tesla has been aiming to start Model Y production at the Gigafactory plant by the end of this year, but like I reported several days ago, it may not happen this year. But the start, that's why I say the time is running out. Anyway, I thank Daniel from FlyBrandenburg channel for this flyover drone. Like I said, I will have his link in the description of this video. Guys, you can see it, and also GF for Tesla, Jürgen, who has been also providing regular Tesla information, as well as Toby Lind, some of whose pictures with permission I'm using in this report. Have a wonderful day. God bless you, everyone. Peace be with all of you, and I'll see you soon in our next report. Let's move on to our next story. When it comes to Tesla Giga Berlin and the local environmental organizations, usually those organizations are viewed little negatively because they seem to hamper and slow down Tesla Giga Berlin's advance and the final approval. But there is also a very good news regarding Brandenburg's environmental green organizations, which we don't hear from the media. So yesterday I found something and I wanted to share it with you. It was reported in top German publication Handelsblatt, and I actually touched on it in my yesterday's Giga Berlin's report, but I want to specifically focus on that today. Brandenburg's Green Party parliamentary group leader Raschke emphasizes the advantages of Tesla Giga Berlin that will Giga Berlin settlement that the Gigafactory will bring to the region. And this is the man who has Brandenburg's Green parliamentary group. You know, the Brandenburg Ministry of the Environment did not yesterday or the day before recently specify a point in time for the decision on the Giga Berlin's approval process. According to a spokeswoman, the comments of critics are still being examined after the online discussion. There are still documents or statements, especially on the area of pollution control and water from authorities, but also there are documents documents from Tesla, she explained. The approval process is ongoing. The important part about this is that recently we didn't know what documents Tesla needed to provide, what are the issues. Its issues are not only related to water but also pollution, and it looks like Tesla also has things to do. Tesla also has points that needs to be discussed. Now, the Greens in Brandenburg see no need to rush. There had to be a decision that was as legally certain as possible regarding Tesla Giga Berlin's final approval, said the parliamentary group leader in the Potsdam State Parliament, Benjamin Raschke. And Raschke says, therefore, quality is more important than speed. Look, they're not against Giga Berlin, but they're saying that, you know, let's make sure everything is in quality, in good quality, like Germans like to do things in good quality, and that the decision that was needs to be as legally certain as possible. Then the Brandenburg's Green Parliamentary Group leader Raschke also emphasized the advantages the Tesla settlement is putting pressure on other manufacturers to quickly transform themselves in the direction of climate-friendly production and mobility, he said. Look at this. Now the green organizations, and I don't know what their position was before, but this is Brandenburg's green parliamentary group leader. He says that Tesla Giga Berlin settling in Grünheide has a lot of advantages, and one of these advantages is putting pressure on the car manufacturers in Germany and elsewhere to quickly transform themselves in the direction of climate-friendly production and mobility. He also said, for us, it is crucial that the infrastructure around the factory is designed as ecologically and sustainably as possible. I think this is all positive, friends, and we can start looking at the green organizations and green parliamentary groups in a very positive way. And I didn't have any negatives in the past if you look at my records. But this is very positive. Things are coming to the construction constructive phase, and according to the Greens, the delivery of raw materials and products for the factory should take place by rail, and the journey to work should be done by using bicycles and bicycle paths. In fact, I've reported about in Grünheide being built bicycle paths for people to come to work in Giga Berlin. So bicycle paths will be closely timed local public transport system. Now, this is Armen Haria from torquenews.com. Friends, please subscribe to our channel for breaking, interesting and unique Giga Berlin news. Please consider support us. I will have my PayPal and Patreon in the first comment. Give us thumbs up if you found this report informative. Have a wonderful rest of the day. God bless you, everyone. And let's move on to our next Tesla story.